Well, one of the things I love about driving through Pioneer Square is seeing all the art galleries. And even after everything that we experienced last year, well, many of the galleries are alive and open for business. To find out what it took to get through the pandemic, I spoke with gallery owner Judith Reinhardt.
So we've been open, we've been hosting exhibitions. I've been doing a lot more virtual outreach that I'd never thought I'd do, where I have artist conversations that I'm recording, and I'm a YouTuber now. Things that you would never think that as an art gallery you would need to do to be able to keep the engagement level up. But I feel like a lot of the galleries, and myself included, have done a really good job at making sure we're presenting our artists in the best possible way in whatever tools we're given to do that.
Right. Which is great. I mean, because art is really the life of a community. And I mean, in your opinion, why do you think people in Seattle continue to buy art at this time, really?
Well, a lot of the clients I've talked to over this past year have been, well, I didn't take this trip to Spain I was going to do, so I really love this piece. Let's do that instead. Or I need something for my Zoom background. Have been part of the conversations, or quite a few of my clients have been in the process of remodeling, and now they're home more. Now they're looking at their space and thinking, I'm going to be here a lot more than I have in the past. What can I do to make it really reflect what I want and what my values are? Versus this is the place I come home to and then leave again the next morning. It's I'm there a lot more. And I feel like that's important.
It really is. I mean, you're staring at the same thing for the last year. You want maybe something new, and what a great investment art is. But let's talk about that. Let's talk about the democratization of art collecting. What does that mean to you? And is art collecting now becoming more accessible? Usually it was just for the super wealthy.
Yes, it is, but it never really was. I mean, I bought my first piece of art when I was making, you know, peanuts, and I was able to do a payment plan over a long period of time, and I still have this piece of art, and it's my favorite thing.
Aww.
So, but getting that entry point in, there's a barrier of either whether it's psychological or something that's I'm not allowed to because I'm not super wealthy. Well, I reject that.
I reject it.
Art is for everybody. Whether you can come and experience it, and if you fall in love with something, any gallery will try to work with you to make it happen. And artists make work in all shapes and sizes. So maybe they do have work that is a little more within your budget. And you can ask those questions.
I think, you know, and I think at a time where, you know, it's hard because there's so much going on. Someone thinks, you know, why would I put a piece of art in, why would I choose that? Well, I think that's the human condition, right? Like, art is important for us to be seeing every day, right?
Oh yeah. I mean, I feel like it connects you to your community. It connects you to this other world. And I think of all the things we could be spending our money on, art puts cash directly in the hands of a working artist who is working, and that's their job, is to make this art. So you're directly affecting somebody else and their ability to pay their bills and ability to live. I feel a lot of artists put their heart and soul out into things, and maybe the return's not there immediately, but other people will connect with it if they're able to see it, whether that's, we all want it to be in person, but if that's not possible, what are we doing to make sure that the images we're putting online represent the work as best as we can? To kind of create that connection, even though it's not going to be the same, there's still that connection, and that's humanity. That's what we want.
Yes, I agree. I'm also interested to hear what your hopes are for Pioneer Square in 2021 and beyond.
Oh, I feel like Pioneer Square is at this kind of precarious moment in time where we've lost a little bit, we've lost some businesses, but the businesses that are here, the small businesses really are the soul of the community. The art galleries are the small businesses in Pioneer Square that are the soul of the community here. So I would love to see more art, more galleries, more restaurants, everything starting to open up to help foster the neighborhood. And I I absolutely 100% believe that it will. It will be a wonderful kind of moment in time to be here over the next couple of years, as I feel like we're on this precipice of something exciting.